Hi, it's Lindley Yaz, and I just want to encourage all of you before I share this news to turn back to God. Repent right now and turn back to Him, run to Him, and run away from this life in the flesh. It's not worth it. And from what God is speaking, that He is calling out to everyone right now to turn back to Him. This is very important and not to be taken lightly. And I just want to encourage you also that God loves you very, very much. You are not alone. So many of us are going through battles right now, deep personal battles. And we just have to stand up and we have to use what God has given us and fight against the enemy and be strong in the Lord. And be strong in the power of His might, and to be on fire for God, and to not let the cares of this world disappoint you or crush you or destroy you. Don't be overtaken with the cares of this world. Only be overtaken by God. Let Him consume you. Let His Spirit consume you. Spend time with Him and be separate from this world. Thank you so much, and thank you to everyone who has been generously giving to this ministry and helping me to continue to do what it is that I'm doing, because after what YouTube has done to my channel by demonetizing a good, I don't know, 80 to 90% of my videos, I think last time I looked, it was about 90%. I'm only able to continue this ministry by your gifts. So for those of you who are led to give, the information is posted below this video. I have a PO box and a PayPal, but I don't want to guilt you into giving either like some people do, because I definitely don't agree with that method. Only do it if God moves you to do it and be prayerful about it. And for those of you who are only able to pray for this ministry, that is also greatly appreciated. Trust me, we are all going through some major spiritual battles right now. So prayer is greatly needed and greatly appreciated. And you are loved and greatly appreciated. God loves you. He sees everything that you're going through. Never feel alone, lost, or forgotten, because God is truly with you. We are all going through battles right now. So be at peace and know that you are never alone. Thank you so much, and God bless you.
It's Lindley Yaz, and wow, so much has happened over the last few weeks. First, we started off with the solar eclipse, and then right after the solar eclipse, all of a sudden we have Hurricane Harvey, which has done major damage in Texas. And we need to remember those people in our prayers, because their lives have just been turned upside down. So as new things begin to happen, let's not forget them. Because now we have the threat of Hurricane Irma. And Hurricane Irma is right now a Category 5 in the Atlantic and headed toward Florida. Now, that one is supposed to hit, I believe, if my memory serves me correctly, Monday or Tuesday. So now we need to pray for the people in Florida. It's already done great damages down in the Bahamas and the little islands down there. So they are saying that Hurricane Irma will make Harvey look like child's play, and we know that Harvey was really bad, so I can't even imagine. Kind of goes along with the prophecies, if it does hit Florida, that people have been having about Florida being underneath water, so let's keep our eyes open. Now, on Irma's heels are two other hurricanes, Hurricane Jose and Hurricane Katia. So who knows what will happen with those? But this is getting huge and out of hand. Now, there are other things that are happening in this nation and in Canada as well that many of you may not be aware of, or if you are, you're not thinking of it because of all the hurricane news. We've got California, Oregon, Montana, and areas of Canada on fire. Texas Gulf Coast is underwater. Southeastern Idaho keeps having multiple earthquakes. Yellowstone is coming to life, and the Trump administration has just issued its harshest nuclear warning to North Korea. And of course, as I said, Hurricane Irma is now a Category 5 in the Atlantic, headed toward Florida. Now, all of these things have happened since the solar eclipse on August the 21st. So for those of you who think the birth pangs aren't starting, I think you should think again, because things are happening. We need to watch these things closely. I've been warning you for a long time now about God's coming judgment, and I've been sharing dreams people have been sending to me and visions and words from the Lord about such things. So we need to just stay in our prayer closets for this nation, because God is, I believe, sending his judgment and trying to wake us up. What's sad is people aren't listening. There are so many people out there, including Christians, who do not think or believe this is God's judgment. Now, I received an email from a gentleman, and I cannot share his name. You just have to trust me on that. This gentleman writes to me every so often, and he stays in his prayer closet. And I'm going to read to you the email that he sent to me. And the last one that he sent to me was right on target. So here I have another one. So I believe his words here are truly from the Lord. And I want you to really prayerfully listen to this and prayerfully pay attention. So we'll refer to this gentleman for now as Mike. And Mike works for the government. That's why I'm unable to give his name. So he is a Holy Spirit-filled Christian, and he constantly stays in prayer and hears from the Lord. So here's what he wrote to me. "Hello, Lynn. The Lord has told me so much in just a couple of weeks, and I really don't know where to start. I am currently on day 216 in my quiet / prayer time with the Lord, and he has revealed to me that 4 judgments are coming. He told me this back on day 205, and I was in shock. He said the first judgment is the hurricanes that are hitting the coasts now. The second judgment will be the earthquakes that will strike both coasts. The third judgment is a massive tidal wave that will hit the east coast and drive water all the way to the mountains. The fourth judgment is so terrible that he would not tell me what it was going to be. The thing is, after each judgment, the Lord is waiting for his body to wake up and repent. He told me that after the first judgment, his body would wake a little bit, but go back to sleep. After the second judgment, his body would wake up a little more, but not be fully awake. After the third judgment, his body would rise up, but still not see that the hand of God was bringing these judgments. People would explain it away, saying it was climate change, or that the earthquake faults have been locked and loaded for years. The tidal wave is what gets the church's attention. I do not know what causes the tidal wave, and he did not tell me. But as he was telling me this, I saw in a vision a massive wave half the height of the Empire State Building in New York. I also saw all the deaths of thousands of people, as there was no warning this wave was coming, bodies stacked up like cord wood. I can guess maybe an asteroid or underwater volcano or nuke. I don't really know. Maybe it could be that the Canary Islands that is split that causes the wave. I just don't know. However, the fourth judgment is the worst. Many will perish in this judgment, which will finally drive the church to its knees, crying out for repentance. I asked of the Lord, what is going to do this? But he said, it is not for me to know. Lynn, ever since the eclipse, I have had an overwhelming, very heavy sense to pray for repentance for this nation. The main thing that I think gets me is the Lord said, before the mess from one judgment is even cleaned up, the next one will strike. Sitting at my desk at work, I silently pray and ask the Lord questions. And I asked him about the hurricanes. He said, they will continue, but be ready for the shaking, for I am trying to wake up my sleeping body. Today, 9/6, or September the 6th, I see that the sun just had an X10 plus solar flare earth facing. That could be the catalyst for the earthquakes. I don't really know. Lynn, yesterday in my prayer time, the Lord told me that the West Coast is going to get hit with a 9.1 earthquake. I thought, Lord, that will cause a lot of damage and deaths. He then told me the 9.1 was a foreshock of the 12.2 that will destroy everything. I am now watching what this solar flare will do to the Earth's tectonic plates. Fukushima earthquake occurred after the Earth got bombarded with a 1.2 M-class flare. This X flare is going to be significantly stronger and more deadly, I think. Now, the next part I'm going to summarize because it was more personal in nature, but he urges all of us to put on the armor of God every day, first thing in the morning and at night, to put on the armor every single day. And he urged me how important it was. And he says, God bless you and your ministry, Lynn, as a watchman. I will keep you updated. He wanted to share this with me. So now you've heard it. So when these things happen, you will know that you were warned. You know, I pray so hard every day that I only put out the truth. And it's very hard because there is so much out there. So I pray that God will somehow supernaturally intervene and only allow me to share the truth. I get a lot of dreams and visions and words from the Lord emailed to me, and I can't share all the dreams. There are a lot of them I do feel are from the Lord, but if I have several that are similar, I have to pick one to share sometimes because it just gets to be a lot of them. But this one really shook me when I read it. And the last one this gentleman shared with me, I shared in one of my previous videos about dreams and prophecies. And I'm telling you, people, if you can't see it, I don't know what's going to wake you up. But terrible times are ahead. Whoever you are out there listening, whether you like me or not, whether you agree with my videos or not, I urge you to at least do one thing. Repent. We don't have any more time. I don't know how the Lord can get your attention. If you do not repent, you will not be under God's protection during these times. When you hear a siren outside for a tornado, what do? You take shelter. You get prepared. You take your family and yourself to the safest place, wherever it is you're at, if you're home, if you're out, you go to the safest place and you take shelter. The only shelter from the things that are coming is Jesus Christ. So you're being warned about the coming storm. It is up to you. If you choose not to take shelter and you want to watch the storm come and sweep you away, you and your family, that is totally up to you. God is warning you to get ready and get right. And the only thing that you can do to protect you and your family from the storms that are lying ahead is to repent and to ask the Lord Jesus Christ into your heart to be your Savior if you haven't already, and to turn away from your sin and to do exactly what God's word says. Quit trying to make excuses or twist the word to conform to what you want to do. You out there listening, you know exactly what God's word says, and you know what it means, and you know what to do. And you who know to do good and do not do it, you're in trouble. I know that my voice may sound harsh right now, but this is told to you in a spirit of love and a spirit of pleading. God is pleading with you through me right now in my voice. I know so many of you are being persecuted, knocked down, beat up by the enemy. I am right now. I am being beat up by the enemy in my home. And in so many different ways, the enemy is trying to just shut us up. The enemy is trying to render us helpless. We cannot let him. This is one of the most important times in biblical history. Each and every one of us who is here alive on this planet today was chosen to be here during this time. You have a choice. The alarm is sounding. The storm is coming. Take shelter in Jesus. Get aboard the ark of Jesus Christ and be safe. And repent now while there is still time, or the storms that are coming are going to wash you away. The ground, when it splits open, is going to suck you in. It will be too late. Again, I say to you, if you hear my voice, look at the things that are happening around you. Look and see. Don't let the world fool you or the naysayers and say, oh, this has just been happening. It's no big deal. It is. This is God's judgment. God is not happy with this nation. God is not happy with things going on in the world. My personal opinion is this nation will become greatly weakened by natural disasters and catastrophes, and then we will be a sitting duck for war. And then the enemy, possibly Russia, is going to come in, and the enemy is going to have its way with us. Now, I would like to send out one word of caution. Something's going to happen that none of us will know about. that will be the reason Russia comes in. They will be coming in because of something else. They're either going to get falsely accused of something that happens or whatnot. We will be deceived into thinking that something that happens is someone else's fault, which will start a war so that we don't look like the guilty party, when in fact the United States of America will be the guilty party. This is God's judgment, people. It is time to listen. It is time to wake up. It is time to get right. Again, what would you do if there was a tornado headed towards your home and the alarms were sounding? This is very real. This is more serious than a tornado alarm. I urge you to get right and get ready. Thank you so much, and God bless you.